I want to stop by again to talk to the black community. I want to talk to the black community, descendants of slaves, the so-called American Negro. I want to tell you something here. This level of intelligence that we're dealing with is gaslighting, it's igniting, you know, for what's happening to us in the country. And we're trying to speak so much dignity to it, which I think that that's a level of respect for us to insert ourselves, and only safety for us to do it that way. We want to talk dignity to a situation that's inhumane and under the belt. We want to talk dignity to that, and we have to be confrontational. This is not a situation where you're allowed not to be confrontational as a black person. I mean, Edward Baldwin said to be consciously, to be open and consciously as a black person is to be enraged. This was a scholar. This is a scholar talking. So you have to understand the principles of this and the sophistication of this. To even understand this and to be sophisticated is another word for smart. You have to, the sophistication of this tells you there's no other way to deal with it when you're treated in this level. Do black people realize the state of emergency and the state of inhumane anchor, the state of senselessness that you're in as a group? You see, a lot of us have jobs. We make it. We're smart. We've been acclimated to deal with situations under the belt. We've been acclimated to deal with situations in subservient matter where we can't really obtain any real concern for one another without having the tools and what it takes to do that. So therefore, we have to survive on our own, and then we begin to build the ideology that, you know, we should have and look at the other person and say, hey, look what I got. This is what happened to a person that's in that space that long. It's a space of poverty. Poverty is adjacent to crime and dysfunction. You don't have what you need. That's why it's called crabs in a bucket. So if I walked into the room and I looked at people fighting and arguing and fussing, and I said, hey, wait a minute, everybody, I'm going to write a $10,000 check. That's not a lot of money. But just to write that to poor people and say, hey, look here, we'll talk about this argument, but let's try to get away from this. And I'm going to give an incentive so everybody can breathe and at least get away from fighting for a minute. Do you think people would change their minds? I do. People would. They would say, hey, whoa, there'll be some, maybe some bruises and bumps there. But somebody may say, hey, they're going to stop and look and wonder what's going on. This person's about to give everybody money. Somebody going to say, hold up, y'all be quiet. Something's going to happen where now people are now functioning. They're not dysfunctioning. They are functioning because of this. This is what government has done to black people. Now everybody's saying, hold on, let's talk about it, let's do diligence, simply because of something like that. Well, this is what I want to say. Everybody's getting that from our government so that they can be people in our society according to what America really is. So I'm going to come and I did this short talk. It's nothing but 2 or 3 minutes. Cut the check for the slave descendants.